Hello again, happy Tuesday. Now the sun has set, but we're still taking a while to cool down. Temperatures across the region, mid to upper 70, 75 here in San Angelo, 77 up in Abilene, 79 over in Sweetwater and Roby. Now over the next few hours, we won't be building any cloud cover. We're going to stay clear, but it's still going to take a while for us to cool down. Typically, we see that cool down happen pretty fast without the clouds, but we're only going to make it to the mid to upper 50s tonight. Some of those far western counties, though, make it to the lower 50s, Garden City, Big Lake, Ozona, making it down to 50 degrees. But here in San Angelo, 55, Abilene, 59. Breaking Ridge is going to be one of those warmer spots tonight, reaching a low of 60 degrees. Now, tomorrow it's going to be slightly cooler than the last 2 days have been, but it's still going to be warmer than average. San Angelo reaching a high of 82. Abilene a little cooler, 77, 73, and Roby, 69 and Snyder. Now, the big difference with the temperatures in the big country in Concho Valley, that cold front that we've been talking about all week will be stalling in the big country early afternoon tomorrow, which is why they won't be able to get so warm tomorrow. And throughout the evening, evening to overnight hours, that's when the front will start making its way through the Concho Valley and on southward. So let's take a look at what that's going to look like. This is tomorrow morning at 6 a.m. Low pressure system just over Oklahoma City with this cold front draped through the Texas Panhandle by about 6 p.m. tomorrow. So the time that you're turning us on, that front will be stalled right in the middle of the Concho Valley here through Tom Green County, which by that time we would have already seen our high of the day. But that's going to help us cool down overnight, and by Thursday morning, that'll be far south of us, and we'll have a high pressure system taking over in the Texas Panhandle, which is going to help keep us with sunny skies in and out the work week going into the weekend. Now, it's too far out to give an accurate forecast, but I do want to talk a little bit about Thanksgiving since that's about 9 days away. This is from the Climate Prediction Center. Around the time of Thanksgiving, this time next week into the end of next week, we're looking at a 30% chance of us being above average. Now, I've said this before, average high for this time of year is around 69 degrees. So that's a very low chance of us being higher than average, which I would guess we will be around the lower to mid 70s. And then there's also a 30% chance of us seeing above average precipitation. So possible rain chances, possible cooler weather looking towards Thanksgiving. But of course, we'll have more detail forecast as we get closer to that day, so just make sure you stay in tune. But to wrap this up with our 7 day, another warm day tomorrow, but once that cold front finishes pushing through, we'll see a cool down on Thursday. We'll start to warm up a bit going into the weekend, but I also mentioned a second cold front coming through on Sunday, helping us start the work week off next week a little closer to average. Same story in Abilene, that cold front might bring some rain chances to them this time next week, but we'll be sure to keep an eye on that. For now, enjoy what's coming on tomorrow. Back to you, Adrian.